गुड मॉर्निंग, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर धर्मपाल सिंह एंड द टुडे टॉपिक इज टाइप ऑफ डेटा मॉडल इन द डीबीएमएस। नाउ कैन सी दैट व्हाट इज द डेटा मॉडल एंड व्हाट कम्स इन योर माइंड व्हेन यू हर्ड द टर्म डेटा मॉडल एंड व्हाट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ दैट। सो फर्स्ट ऑलरेडी आई हैव डिस्कस्ड द व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ डेटा एंड मॉडल मीन्स व्हाट। What comes in a model means some structure will be there, some format will be there where data can be. Data, when I want to store the data, we have to follow it. So here data model is saying that, suppose I can give the example, suppose I want to live. So I want to purchase some flat. So they can give the example 3 BHK. This is one type of model, means I can understand 3 BHK mean the bedroom will be there, hall will be there, three rooms will be there, like that. 2 BHK, where it comes in mind that yeah, 2 BHK means this type of things are available. So same thing is applicable for the data model. When I want to store the data, we have to follow the certain type of model to store the data. Here you can see that data models define how the logical structure of database is modeled. Means I want to go for the creation of the data, then how our data will be followed and that will be stored in a particular location. Data model are fundamental entities to introduce abstraction in a DBMS. Suppose I want to store the data model. Suppose I want to take one example of building there. In the building, we have no certain abstractions are there. Means the first I know that according this is my flat, 2 BHK, 3 BHK, whatever the. After the many extra things are there, like the lift is there, parking is there, and how can maintain the building with us, security of the, like many things are there. So this type of abstraction is also provided in the data model there. Suppose first level means the admin officer can access this model. Second level, this model. So by using the data model, we are able to create this one. Third level, suppose I can say that other person will be access the data there. The first level I can say administrator, second level programmer, third level the user. So this type of thing I can create. When you want to create any database, that comes, that first thing is that you have to think about the model, which model I want to follow, and based on that model structure, we have to create it. Okay. So now we can see that the data model define how data is connected to each other and how they are processed and stored inside the system. Suppose I want to say that, suppose we heard the term, suppose I want to create the college database. So I can follow any model. Later on, we know that you can follow many models there. The first one, I know that I can create that table, I create that table, I create that table, and how one table are related with each other. So when you follow the data model, all the things must be clear to you. I follow this model, and this model have this type of abstraction, and this model also have the connection between the data in this way. So this is the meaning of the data model. Means when you want to go for the design of any database, we have to follow the structure. Same whenever I want to go to design of any building, we have to follow some structure. So that thing is applicable here. Now you can see here types of the data models. What are different types? You can say first one is saying that the record-based model. Second one, including the record-based model, you can say relational model is there. Network model is there, hierarchical models is there, and after that, second one is the ER diagram, famous one, ER model or ER diagram models are there, and object-oriented model is there. So in this later one slide, we are going to learn that. Now you can say record-based model. Or you know that it mentioned the relational model, it mentioned the hierarchical model, it mentioned the network model. So first, we have to know that the network model, hierarchical model. We can say this hierarchical model, what is the structure? Here you can see that. There is the department. Department have the what? Number and the name there. And after this one, I can say course there, student there. Within the course, professors are there. So here what we can see there in hierarchical model. If I say this is the your parents and these two are the your child there. Again, this is the parent and this is your child there. So this is the same like the tree structure. entry structure. We can say this is the parent, these two are the child. For this one, this is the child, and for this one, this is the parent there. Hierarchical model follow in this. So this is the first level of hierarchical, second level, and third level. Here, whatever the values here, because you know that inheritance property, so whatever the values is there, you can able to access from this part. Similarly applicable here, similarly applicable. So this type of model, we can say mainly we are following IBM also. Okay. So this model is helpful, but there is some problem. Suppose it may be possible that some, if I say the relation between this one, some student also attend the class of the professor. It may be possible that. So here what we can say that, because we know that according to tree, child have only one parent. Here required two parents, so it will be not applicable here. Because it may be possible that the student are attending the classes of the professor. If I create again the student and link it, it will be extra wastage of your table there. If you want to make the direct connection between this, it is not possible, because according to tree property, that just like the tree property, child have only one parent there. So that is the problem here. And how we can solve this? So by using the relational model, we can solve it. Now you can see that in this figure, here in this figure we can go for the, we can overcome the problem of the your earlier one. You can see this professor are part of the these two, this one and this two. So here in the network model, entity are organized in graph in which some entity can be accessed to several paths. I mean, just like one child have the many parent there, just like the network model means one computer is connected with the second one connected with third one. One is also connected with third one, like that. The network model overcome the problem of the given situation. You can see here, easily we can say that more than one person. Suppose if the student, I can go for this one, and the department, I can also go for this one. So there no extra thing will be required. But problem is that here we can see that many things, IDs are common. You can see IDs common. And also the some places names are common there. So this type model is a very easy because you can follow it. But problem is that in this type of model, we have to go for the maximum interdependency there. If any changes happen here, that changes must be reflected here. That must be reflected here. So this model required a lot of changes when the any change occur in the different area which are dependent on particular part. So how can solve this one? Then the concept of the relational model comes. Relational model is nothing but it is the form of the table, where table, we can say these are the attributes. Be careful. Table is also known as the relation there. So don't be confused. In SQL, when you go for design of the table, so that is the same thing as the relational model. I can also say the table as the relation. So don't get confused here. Okay. So here you can see that this model, SID, these are S name, S age, these are the known as the attribute and also the column of the table. Okay. Attribute means what? Attribute means suppose you are the student. Then how I can recognize that you are the student of GIS college? Obviously, you have the email ID. Obviously, you have the GIS college roll number, name and college ID there. So means attribute means why we are using. Attribute is saying that this is the property, by using that we can recognize the entity. Entity means same thing, I mean unique thing, because many students are there. And within the many students, I can easily recognize you because you are the unique between all the 60 students or 120 students. So entity means it is the unique things and object in real world that is distinguishable from all other things and object in real world. Means many students are there, but we are able to recognize you because you are unique among all the 60 students. So that is the meaning of entity. Or within the entity, how I can recognize the particular entity from the entity set required the help of the attributes there. So now you can see the attributes here. By taking the help of attributes, I can easily recognize. You can see this table, it has almost a 5 student. If I want to recognize this particular student, I want to know the name of the 1101, how I can go for it? So easily here I can say that select select student name from the student table where S ID equal to 101, 1101. So easily it will be give the value from the this table, because here S ID is the unique ID here. And easily I can recognize. So relational model is saying this just formed of the table. Column is the attribute and the row is known as the tuple. Tuple means the value of the your entity. Okay. So these three models we can follow. And these three models is known as record base. Means based on the record we can design. Based on the record means whatever the records we have. Based on the record we have designed the this type of model there. Now the we can go for the second part. Suppose relational model, what are the benefits? Main highlight of the relational model are data is stored in table called relation. Already mentioned that the here relation means I can say suppose relation you have to understand this is feature is saying that about the table there. Okay, relation can be normalized. Here I already mentioned in network model many things are common there and it is very create problem when you go for the update there. But if you use the relational model when you follow the technique of normalization like first normal, second normalization, third normalization, and the DCNF and 4NF and 5NF. So that technique can be minimized. Keep in mind that not overcome. It is not possible to overcome because I already discussed in first lecture. It is not possible to overcome the all the redundancy between from the table. But still we can minimize and also insert, delete, update anomalies. We can also minimize by using the normalization technique on the relational model. In normalized relation, value save are atomic value. Means that there is some condition of the first normal form. All the attribute are the atomic. Atomic means, here I can give the example. Suppose if I say like the attribute name. So name, we can say that I can divide the name into the three part, like first name, middle name, last name. So here we are able to divide. So this is not the atom. But if I say that your college ID, in college ID, I say 1, 2, 3, 4, it is not possible to divide that. So college ID is the atomic here, but name is the your non-atomic there. So we are able to divide. Okay. So here we have to be careful that here the condition of the first normal form is that your all the data, all the attribute must be the atomic there. So here you can say you are easily managed there because the your all the relation are the have the atomic value. Now we can go for the second one. Each row in the relation contain a unique value. I already given this example. If you go each table here, we can see that here many things are there. It may be possible that 14, 14 age are common. Also the class is common, sections are common there. And it may be possible, so name is also common. It may be possible, but here ID will be different. We have seen this thing in real life that it may be possible that all the student out of three have the same name, but all the student not have the same roll number. So that is thing it is saying that each row in the relation contain a unique value. It must have the some. Each column in relation contains value from a same domain. Just like here, same domain means they're saying that if I say SID and if I declare SID as the like number, so all the value will be number. If I declare S name as the character type, all the value will be number. Similarly in this part, similarly in this part, similarly in this part. Suppose I can also declare the worker. Worker means it is the variable character. It is also take the number. We can also take the character there. So whatever the value, because here this line is saying that each column in the relation contains value from the same domain. Means it is saying that whatever the domain we have defined that, that domain, all the value is the same. It does not mean that the in row one, I have stored the integer here. And in the second row, same column, same domain, I have stored the character. It is not possible. So this type of benefit we can get from the relational model. Domain means, sometimes ask that what is the mean? Domain is the set of permitted value of the attribute is known as the domain. What is permitted value of this thing? Number type. Permitted value of this name type. Permitted value of this is also number. This is also number and this is the character. So this is the meaning of domain. Now ER model. Now you can see that JSON term are there. We can see the terms here, which is mentioned, like the attributes, attribute, entity, relationship. From the term, we know that entity relationship model there. So this model will be required when you go for the design of the database. Suppose when you go for the design of database, simple forget about the design of the database. Just think about that. Suppose I want to go to design a building. So what we required here? If I want to design a building, what I will require here? When you go for design a building, first thing is that you have to see the design, the blueprint of the building. Okay. After the design of the blueprint, you can show to the customer. Customer is agreed, like kitchen will be there, bathroom will be there, like that. After that, we can convert this blueprint into the physical design. So same thing is applicable here. Before going to design of your any database, the first task is that keep in mind that we have to go for the design of your ER diagram. When you go for the design of the ER diagram, so first we can design what are the entities. Means suppose I take the example of college database, what are the entities may be possible? I already mentioned the definition of entity. Entity is the things and object in real world that is distinguishable or have the unique property as compared to the other there. Just like I have given the example, in group of the student table, roll number one is the one entity, roll number two is also entity because we are able to recognize the roll number one and roll number two also. Even case of the in your college, we have seen that in a computer, there is some mark like JIS01, CSE, room number 209, like that. So what is the meaning? We are able to recognize this particular computer. JIS means this is JIS college, room number 209 means it belongs to room 209, and CSE means this is department of CSE, and 13 means, the 10 means it is the computer number 13. Here it is also entity. So whatever the things are there in real world, we are able to recognize it, that becomes the entity. So we know that attribute means, I already mentioned characteristic of entity, how we can recognize the entity there. So by using the attribute, we can recognize the entity from the entity set. These are the entity and how I can recognize it from the your attributes. So what is the relationship? What is the need of the relationship there? We know that student there, I can create a single table of student. Teachers are there, I can create a single table of teacher. And the department is there, I can create a single table of department. So what is the need of this? Here need is there because we know that in case of your real world, student and teacher have the relation. Student are attending the classes of teacher. Teacher are taking the classes of the student. In real world, they have the relation. So when I want to convert this real world data in form of your database, that must have the connection. So that is when I have mentioned the definition of database is there. Database is the collection of interrelated data. Okay, that is the thing. So here, suppose if I say this is the teacher takes classes of student. So teacher have teacher ID, teacher name, teacher mobile number, teacher department. Similarly, student have student ID, student name, student department. This type of things are present. Later on, when you go for the ER diagram, you can discuss the thing in more detailed way. Now you can go for the object-oriented model there. The third part is that we know that the object-oriented data model is based upon real-world situation there. Just like we have used the term, many terms like that. ER diagram is there. ER diagram has some limitation because earlier we know that hierarchical model is there. We are not able to connect the hierarchical model with the, if have the more than one parent here. We follow the network model. Network model, too many dependencies are there. An automatic object is not possible. We follow the concept of relational model. Relational model, we can store the data by normalization technique and minimize the dependency also. This is the good. An ER diagram and object data model is showing that ER diagram, I already discussed that when you go for the design of anything, so we have to do the things in the paper there and that paper is complete one, then I can go for the design of the physical structure. Now the things is, what is the need of the object-oriented data model? In object-oriented data model, many properties are there, like we heard the terms, inheritance properties are there, and also polymorphism is there. That can be not supported by the your ER model. So that is the reason we have to go for the object-oriented model. Now here you can see that object-oriented model oriented data model is based upon the real-world situation. You know that what is the need of that is the same thing. This situation are represented as object with different attributes. Here the situation means that I can say that suppose I want to create the student, so either the student will be there, and the objects are represented with the different type of attribute there. Situation are represented as object with the different attribute. And also the you can see the third line that all these objects have multiple relation between. Okay, so all the objects have the multiple relation, just like the your multiple inheritance concept. If I use polymorphism, also the same thing, I can use different ways. So these are the things. Here the how we can represent. Here you can see that your entity is represented by rectangle, this is by the ellipse, this is the diamond shape. So similarly, the object-oriented model have the same structure, like circle has the attribute center and radius. Rectangle has the attribute length and width. Suppose if I go for the suppose the of a circle, what is the attribute of the circle? Center and radius there. Rectangle has the length and width as the your attributes there. Triangle has the base and height as the attribute. The object circle, rectangle, triangle inherited from the object shape. Suppose there is a one object like shape. Within the shape, we can say different type of attribute, like for circle this one, rectangle this one, triangle for this one. We are able to. So this is the your concept of the data model. So I think that it is a better for you to understand. Thank you.